Welcome to Vegas, baby. I want you to come and play me. Give me the money, give me diamonds, give me rubies, baby. Take me on that trip, I wanna go shopping. Get on your knees and beg me, please, to let you eat me.
I eat this every day. Update.
Everyday cooking, part 5, garlic honey potatoes. Boil those in salted water until they're just fork tender. Coat them in corn flour, then into a hot pan with some oil. When they're nice and crispy, we're going to go in with some garlic, we're going to go in with some honey, some soy and some chili oil if you fancy it, and then they're ready to go.
So this is what I'm having for lunch today. So I'm gonna have my signature sandwich. If you've been on this page before, you've seen me make this. First layer beef pastrami, second layer turkey, third layer beef pastrami. Then you gotta go Gouda cheddar, that's important. Then some salt and vinegar chips, cause y'all know I love sour. And of course we have turkey bacon, then some lettuce, then we put some tomato, then salt, pepper, oregano, and red wine vinegar. And y'all, I love to close up and hear that crunch. And look how good it's about to look. Ooh. And y'all, I got these strawberries from Publix yesterday that taste like candy. So I'm gonna have some of those on the side. And then for the bev, I'm gonna have some sweet tea, but I feel like that's gonna be too sweet with the strawberries. But anyways, that's what I'm having for lunch today.
I don't think you have any idea how insane this is. Spicy garlic butter pasta, let's go. Salt your boiling water and cook your pasta. In a separate pan on low heat, add your olive oil and garlic slices until they're crispy and golden and set aside. Add a knob of butter to your garlic oil, chili flakes, oyster sauce, soy sauce, and give it all a mix. 3 minutes before your pasta is al dente, transfer it over to the pan. You want to finish cooking it off here. Add some pasta water, give it a toss, then go in with your chives and parmesan and give it another toss until evenly coated. Then all you've got to do is serve it up with some sesame seeds. This is completely optional, but you can use some crispy chili oil like I did, and do not forget about your crispy golden garlic chips. Now this is the time for you to do the shlurp shlurp.
So ridiculously good.
And if it doesn't make you feel like this, you are lying, because
how you like that?
Here's my favorite healthy creamy chicken. It's so easy and absolutely delicious. Cut your chicken into cubes, marinate with olive oil, garlic powder, paprika, basil, red chili flakes, and salt. Mix till well combined. Then for the sauce, you need 1/2 cup milk, low-fat cream cheese, parmesan, and seasoning mix you see on screen. Blend it all up till silky smooth. Then cook your chicken for 4 minutes. Flip, lower the heat, and add the sauce. Handful of spinach, cover for a couple minutes and mix it all together. Let it simmer and thicken for 5 minutes. Serve with some rice, and trust me, you're gonna love this.
healthiest, low-calorie, crispy, sweet chili chicken that you'll ever try. And it's so quick and easy to make. Start by mixing together corn flour with smoked paprika, salt and pepper, then give it a good shake. Add diced chicken breast, just don't miss like I did, and shake it again. Cook the chicken to a pan on medium to high heat, and once it's nice and golden brown, set it to the side. Turn it down to low heat and add light soy sauce, light sweet chili sauce, sriracha, garlic, and ginger, then stir everything together. Add a little bit of honey, stir it again, then add your chicken and mix it together to coat it completely. Serve with rice, sesame seeds, chili, spring onion, and capsicum or your choice of sides. Enjoy.
I have been seeing this spaghetti all over my For You page, so I finally tried it, and y'all, it was so good. Start off by browning a pound of beef, add onions, bell pepper, season it with whatever you want, and then go ahead and add a jar of your favorite spaghetti sauce. Let that simmer for a bit, and then we can start working on our pasta. Today, I'm using the Fasta Pasta Microwave Pasta Cooker. You can measure, cook, and strain pasta all in one container. So while this is cooking, let's work on the Alfredo sauce. Melt a stick of butter, add in a little minced garlic, 2 cups of heavy whipping cream, and 2 cups of Parmesan cheese. Season with salt and pepper, and then let it thicken up. When the pasta was finished, I put the lid on, strained it, and threw it right into my casserole dish. I added my Alfredo sauce, and then I topped it with my meat mixture and added more mozzarella and parsley on top. Bake on 350 for 15 minutes, and then top it with more Parmesan cheese.
I think I like when it rains.
Welcome to my new 15-minute dinner series, where I'm teaching you how to make simple, delicious, healthy dinners in just 15 minutes using supermarket, affordable, accessible ingredients that you're going to absolutely love and make it onto your weekly rotation. So if that's a bit of you, drop me a follow for this new series and let me help you.
Here's my new favorite way of making healthy chicken and rice taste absolutely delicious. Cut your chicken breast in half, marinate with olive oil, garlic, oregano, cumin, paprika, salt, squeeze half a lemon, then mix well. Then medium heat, add uncooked rice, season with turmeric, paprika, cumin, lightly toast. Then add water, bring to a boil, then let it simmer on low heat till cooked. Next, cook your chicken on high heat for 4 minutes on each side till golden. Then you're ready to plate the rice, shredded lettuce, cherry tomatoes, the chicken, a generous amount of yogurt sauce, and sriracha, and you're ready to feast. Enjoy!
Wonton mozzarella sticks. So good and so simple to make. Start with some string cheese and place that into the center of an egg roll wrapper. Tuck in the sides, roll it up, and seal it shut with water. Place it into the air fryer and spray it with nonstick spray, 400 degrees for 10 minutes, flipping halfway. Once it's golden brown, serve with marinara sauce and enjoy.
The baddest of them all.
Into the thick of it.